exactly how that happens or which personnel will be brought.
You're watching News Now from Fox. I'm Daytona Everett. We are cutting into that update coming from the Biden campaign to bring you a live report from Phoenix, Arizona. Big news coming out of Arizona for that Senate race today. Officially, Martha McSally has conceded to Mark Kelly in that race. And we have Fox 10's Matt Galka out here in Phoenix, Arizona to kind of break it all down for us. Matt, what is this timeline looking like, and why is this such a big deal today?
Well, good afternoon. You know, it's been 10 days since Election Day, and on election night, we had heard from Mark Kelly that night, and it wasn't a boisterous, it wasn't an over-the-top victory speech. It was pretty calm for the time because the votes were still being counted, and the math necessarily didn't add up to a Mark Kelly victory last Tuesday. But it became more apparent as the days went on that Mark Kelly would indeed win Arizona's Senate seat and defeat Martha McSally. So now what we're looking at, it's not a typical timeline for a lot of new congressmen and women where they get sworn in January. This was a special Senate election, so Mark Kelly could be sworn in by the end of the month as soon as the election results in Arizona are certified, because he is taking over for the late Senator John McCain in this special election. And in another 2 years, he'll try to defend that seat against any GOP challengers. So he can get sworn in before many of the other men and women around the country who have won their races in Congress get sworn in, like I said, perhaps by the end of the month.
Matt, the Fox News decision desk, as I'm sure you know, called that race on election night. Why did it take 10 days?
You know, that's a good question. There's a lot of theories out there. I laugh because I know most of them, but I'm sure many of your viewers know a lot of the theories that are out there. You know, when it comes down to it, the math just didn't add up in this one. Mark Kelly had a decent amount lead, decent enough on election night, and that lead, it shrank a little bit in the past 10 days, but not nearly enough where Senator McSally could mount a comeback. I actually, when I talked to Mark Kelly earlier today, I asked him, why is it that you think she hasn't conceded yet? And he didn't know. He didn't want to get into it. He didn't want to get into any of the theories. Funny enough, about an hour after our interview ended, Senator McSally did end up conceding. She released a statement and said she called Senator-elect Mark Kelly and wished him well on the transition to Washington. So all's well that ends well, and it's nice to see two challengers, not bitter per se, but two challengers congratulating each other as Senator-elect Kelly thanked Martha McSally for her service not only to the country but also to Arizona. So a nice bit of friendship to be shown when we don't often see it in these tough races that go on during the election season.
Right. In that conversation with Mark Kelly, did you talk about next steps, what he's going to be focusing on in his tenure?
Yeah, we sure did. And you know, earlier this week, Kelly has already gone to D.C. for a couple of days, and he's put together his transition team. And while it might not seem like it, he did put together a bipartisan transition team, which is pretty standard for a lot of people, even though it might not seem like it today in this hyper-partisan environment we live in. He's got Democrats, Republicans, independents on there. So he met with his full team already this week, and the next steps really are some administrative things, but also getting to work. Like I said, he could be in the Senate as soon as the end of this month and start voting on bills or start proposing bills pretty quickly. And what he talked about were the top priorities he talked about heading into this election, which were getting COVID-19 under control, getting a plan out there as we see case numbers continue to rise, and also the Affordable Care Act. He talked about the case right now in front of the Supreme Court. And he was optimistic that the entire Affordable Care Act wouldn't be struck down, maybe only parts of it. But he said, in the end, you don't know. So there's still work to be done on both of what I would say are both of his top priorities there.
Matt, you tweeted out something interesting that he wanted to honor the late John McCain, in which Martha McSally actually took over his spot. Can you talk a little bit about that, what his plans are for that, along with Barry Goldwater as well?
Yeah, that was interesting. I had asked him, are you going to bring anything uniquely Arizona with you to Washington, D.C.? And he said he had recently spoken to Cindy McCain about trying to get the desk that John McCain sat at over the course of his time in the Senate, and is the same desk that Barry Goldwater sat at. And he said it would mean a lot to him if they could get that done. So a nice tribute to two really iconic Arizona figures. And Mark Kelly would like to keep that tradition going in Washington.
All right, very cool to hear right there. That's Fox 10's Matt Galka out here in Phoenix, Arizona. We appreciate you.
Appreciate you. Thank you.
All right. So again, you are watching News Now from Fox. We're bringing you all of the latest election news. Of course, breaking news coming out of Arizona today, which is one of those really, really looked at races across the country. A big one as Arizona flipped blue, and also for the presidential race as well, with Martha McSally now today conceding to Mark Kelly out here in Arizona. So big stuff coming across the country today. We're going to send some of you off to a quick commercial break, but we will leave you with this beautiful